Hello everyone, this is Somya and you're watching Global Tales. Our life is a beautiful long journey and our body acts as a vehicle that helps us commute from one destined goal to another. So this body needs to be taken care of in a very good and efficient way so that we can go a very long way ahead. And in this long journey, it's very natural that we might get attracted towards shortcuts. So today's video is all about the common mistakes that we all tend to make in our fitness journey in order to get our goals reached faster, along with the consequences so that they don't get into the similar kind of situations and realize the importance of long-term health and fitness in their life. First and foremost common mistake that I did in my initial days of fitness journey was over-exercising and over-exerting my body. It's very common and I think most of you can relate to me that when we set a target for ourselves, we get really very excited in the initial day and we really get motivated to just achieve it as soon as possible without caring much about the consequences. Our body is just like this rubber band. Much elastic and you can push it as much as you can. If pushed way too harder, it will break down. And once it's gone, you are left with nothing. No enthusiasm, no zeal, everything is just over. Exercising is definitely a very good thing, but too much of any good thing can often lead to a serious problem. And your body is like a machine. If you overuse it, it will actually break down not only your physical health but your mental strength that is very much required to achieve a goal. This was a very common mistake that I used to do in my initial days, till then when I realized the importance of health in my life. The reality is that when you overexercise, you don't even actually get the results. Once you reach the weight loss plateau, that is when you're not seeing the results anymore, is the reason that you have actually pushed yourself so harder in the initial days that your body has been used to that initial torture that you have given to it, and now it won't respond to that routine. So make out a workout plan that is strategically viable, that you can increase in future, because it's not a matter of two or three goals that we set for ourselves, rather it's a matter of a lifelong journey. Another common mistake that I used to do was overthinking and overstressing myself and taking that pressure of being fat.
Nahi jaldi se taiyar ho ja, function mein jana hai.
Main nahi jaungi.
Kyun?
Mera man nahi hai. Mujhe padhna hai.
Very late in my journey, I realized that importance of people in our life is very momentary, and thinking too much about what they will think of yourself and about your body is just temporary. What matters is what you feel about yourself. If you feel fit and happy, then that's the only thing that matters at the end of the day. I too realized this very late in my life, but yes, people really doesn't matter. The next common blunder that I used to make in my initial days of fitness journey was to monitor my weight the very next second I exercised. This is a very stress increasing exercise. Whenever you monitor your weight and if it doesn't actually get to a place where you want to, you actually tend to enhance your stress levels and release a hormone called cortisol that increases the insulin level in your body. As a result, you crave more for sugary and fatty food, and this leads to tremendous amount of weight gain and you feel really demotivated. Coming to the most popular blunder nowadays.
इतनी मेहनत तुम सोमया क्यों कर रही? ये मेरे एक मिलने वाले ने दिया एक पाउडर, है ना? गारंटीड रिजल्ट है, एक महीने में 10 किलो वजन कम हो जाएगा। लो, यूज करो।
Adopting a shortcut is always easy and seems to be very attractive. Think of it in a very long term. Will you be able to live on that powder for all your life? Can you leave your diet like your breakfast or meal for all your life? No, know, it's not really possible. So just don't focus on short-term results. Focus on a long-term journey that will give you happiness for your entire life. Talking about these supplements, there are certain minerals and vitamins that are required by a body to function well. And because of our unhealthy lifestyle, you're not getting it naturally. So that's okay if we go for a supplement for a vitamin D tablet because we are not able to get the sunlight appropriately. But weight loss supplements are highly not recommendable because they won't give you a long-term result. The another common mistakes that we often do is to correlate fitness with our physical appearance. There are many people who don't even look that thin or slim, but they are actually very fit. So it's not about the way you look, it's actually about how much fit you are. And so don't actually get attracted towards these body shapers or these, because they just make you look thin. They don't actually make you look fit. In initial days, I really didn't understand the difference between healthy eating and dieting. Our body is similar to like a car, and it requires a fuel in form of nutrients like vitamins and minerals to sustain for a longer journey. To maintain that high efficiency and maintain that average, the body needs that fuel in form of nutrients. For losing weight, you need to maintain that calorie deficit. So the calories that you take should be from the nutritious source and not from the unhealthy sources. So make sure that you have a proper diet and you don't restrict yourself to dieting and starving yourself, because starving doesn't really help in the long term. You can't really diet for a long term. So just have a healthy, nutritious food and develop a healthy lifestyle, as I always say. Another common mistake that I used to do, and I think most of you must have been doing, that after exercising you feel that you have done a lot of exercise, now you can have whatever you want. It's the calorie deficit that has to be maintained, and the calories should be from the nutritious source, as I told you. So if you are burning a lot of calories, it doesn't mean that you are just actually overshadowing it by having a pizza after that. Sources of your calories should be nutritious. It's a natural human tendency that whenever you are kept away from something that you like, you tend to get attracted towards it more. Research showed up that if you crave for something and you are not letting yourself having it, a day or two after that, you will end up thinking about it so much and you will develop that likability to an extent that you will end up eating that entirety three times the amount that you were planning to eat. For example, if I'm craving about a cake or a pastry that I really like and really wanted to eat, but I'm not able to do it just because I am on a diet and I will gain weight, so it will actually force me to get attracted towards that cake or a pastry so much that I will end up eating it more than the amount I was planning to. So whenever you feel like eating anything, just satisfy your taste buds with your cravings, because if you don't really do it, you will increase your cravings and compel yourself towards that food more and more. It's better to have things in moderation rather than to completely cutting them off. So these were some mistakes that I experienced through my weight loss journey and many others around me. So I just wanted to let my viewers know that don't fall into the trap of these shortcuts. You might take a shortcut and reach to your goal fast, but you will never remember the path that you followed because you actually never looked at it. And the beauty actually remains in the process. So start loving your surroundings, start loving the process that you are actually into for achieving your goal. Start loving your healthy lifestyle, develop a healthy eating habits, develop a workout regime. That is the actual beauty of the process and the real goal that you need to achieve. So that's it for this video. I hope you find it useful. I really wanted to share this with my viewers. And if you do, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends, family and everyone, because your sharing actually motivates me to work harder. And comment below if you have any questions regarding weight loss, or you can mail me. I will respond to your mails every weekend, because that's the time when I get to respond to your mails, and I will respond to your comments as soon as possible. So yeah, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and comment below if you have any questions. Bye bye.